Here are some local corporate headlines. Megaworld building its third residential condominium in General Trias, Cavite. The 14-story Maple Park residences will have smart home units and an e-vehicle charging facility. It is expected to generate 1.8 billion pesos in sales and is scheduled for completion in 2028. Megaworld shares slipped nearly 8% in Thursday trade. PhilInvest Land to develop a 25-hectare innovation park in Calamba City, Laguna. The company broke ground on its innovation park Ciudad de Calamba on an expansion of its PESA Ecozone PhilInvest Technology Park. Once completed, it will lease ready-built factory and built-to-suit units. PhilInvest Land shares stayed flat. Ital Pinas subsidiary IDC Prime signs a joint venture for the development of a 1.2 billion peso mixed-use project. The development project will be located at a 6,800 square meter property in Cagayan de Oro City. IDC Prime will be entitled to 80% of sellable units. Shares of Ital Pinas rose 1.2%. And finally, 25 McDonald's stores in the Philippines are now solar-powered. The company says this will allow them to save nearly 550,000 kilowatts per hour annually. McDonald's Philippines President and CEO Kenneth Yang adds they hope to find more solutions to make operations greener and more efficient.
Philippine Tourism Department eyeing to launch layover tours for airline passengers with connecting flights at Manila's main gateway. That move is seen to boost the local tourism industry. The agency says they're finalizing the details of the project. It adds that tours can be linked to the planned hop-on, hop-off bus tour for the Pasay and Parañaque route that will be launched in October.
We still have a lot of things to do before that the layover tours are made available for our domestic, lalo na for our international tourists. But the hop-on-hop-off program will be a good platform to help it speed it along. Secretary Cristina Garcia-Ferrez is really keen into opening up the country and offering a seamless experience for everyone.
Meanwhile, a hotel group is also looking to boost domestic tourism as well as the hospitality sector. It's launching in September a month-long online sale, which would offer up to 70% discount in accommodations. But the group also admits the hospitality sector is in urgent need of more workers, with more businesses opening up post-pandemic.
We still have a shortage because a lot of our sales and marketing professionals in the hospitality industry have moved elsewhere. No,
right.
You know, the hospitality industry is we are the recruitment platform.
Yeah.
No, because they always say that hoteliers are always very resilient. Sanay kami magtrabaho ng walang oras. We work on holidays. We work very long hours. So technically speaking, you know, we are being poached.
Because of the opening of the hotels and there were fewer, you know, graduates of tourism, it's really difficult to find qualified applicants for the position. Even entry-level position, we're having a hard time.
The Philippine government officially opens the public bidding for the rehabilitation of Manila's International Airport. The Marcos administration is inviting both local and foreign firms to bid for the contract to rehabilitate, operate, optimize, and maintain the NAIA. The project carries a 170.6 billion peso price tag and covers all facilities of the airport, including its runways and four terminals. It aims to increase the current annual airport capacity from 35 million to at least 65 million. Government had earlier turned down an unsolicited proposal worth 267 billion pesos submitted by a group of six of the largest conglomerates in the country.
Let's check on European markets first. Shares in the region are hitting one-week highs as the blowout earnings from chipmaker Nvidia give a boost to tech stocks. Easing bond yields across Europe also providing a lift. As for Wall Street, futures for the Dow have turned negative, but contracts tied to the tech-heavy Nasdaq are surging, with Nvidia's stock jumping nearly 8% in pre-market trade. The world's most valuable chipmaker posted stunning quarterly results after the close Wednesday, with revenues doubling to $13.5 billion during the second quarter.